as we all know, it's crucial time and we are forced to sit in a lockdown situation. And we don't know when this situation will be over. As parents, we are worried about our children's safety and we are concerned for loss of their time for learning. Moms have big challenge to keep their children happy and busy so that these little munchkins, they don't become monsters in their super active time. Here I'm sharing few activities and few topics which you might find useful. The very first important thing is to give them healthy meals. Kids tend to eat lots of junk in holidays, so please make sure you are giving them lots of fruits and vegetables. The very first activity which you could do, it's a fun activity and adults can also do it with them. It's hide and seek. Hide and seek is very good for their brain development. As children, they are learning to plan. When they are trying to hide, their brain is constantly thinking and planning where they're gonna hide, what place they will be fitting in, and what sort of place they can hide where no one can see them. So it's a kind of good brain development. You can make this simple game more interesting by making it musical and using these terms. They might show you impulse control sometimes by saying, "I'm here," and slowly these muscles get strengthened and they learn self-control, emotion regulation, communication, flexible thinking, teamwork if they're playing with their siblings. Second activity you could do is musical chairs. Through musical chairs, they learn to focus and it's fun game. You just need players, chairs and music. You can play this game indoor or outdoor in your garden. You could put all the chairs in a circle and here they are learning shape too. It's a family game. It's fun for adults too. There are some nice music pieces on YouTube, especially for musical chair just for this game. I'm giving the link below in description for your convenience. In lockdown situation, we all are worried about our weight. So here's a good opportunity for doing exercise with kids. And yoga can be made fun by relating it to animals. For example, you can pose as a cat, you can pose as a dog, rabbit or snake. And when you hiss in that asana, kids, they love it. So moms can do this exercise. Just simply do Tadasana by stretching up and say that you are a tree. Kids, they love to become tree. Or simply stretch exercises and become an aeroplane. So things like that. You can make it interesting by relating it to interesting animals or characters. You can use any big cardboard box lying in your garage from your fridge or washing machine and just make a hideout point for them by giving some nice cushions inside, or you can actually cut it from the top of the card box and hang their different colors stockings or socks. Or you could use your dining table. Under the dining table, just lay some nice cushions, blanket, and give them books to read. And you can actually create a color theme. If they love blue color, just use all the blue cushions, blue blankets, and you could keep some blue toys over there. So you could create a color theme in their fort. So building a fort is another interesting activity which could keep them busy for hours. Treasure hunt can be organized outdoors or indoors if you don't have enough space. You could take a box of rice and if you like, you can color the grains, or you could take lentils and kidney beans and hide their favorite candies and lollies or their favorite toys. It's a very good exercise for their brain. Coloring can keep them busy for hours. If you don't have enough coloring books, you could actually print some templates and formats from the internet. Nursery rhymes with actions can be included in their fun time. It's all about your attitude to create fun. You could create some props, whatever available in your house environment. And for example, family finger nursery rhyme. If you have a glove in your house, or just paint it on your fingers, or whatever easy for you, you could create fun in nursery rhymes. Next activity is beading, which is good for their fine motor skills. You could give them some shoestrings, woolen threads, or some buttons or beads to make a friendship band. Or if you don't have any beads in your house, you could simply cut the straws. You could give them macaroni, pasta, or color the pasta, and they could create beautiful necklaces out of pasta. You could give them barbecue sticks and some beads to insert, and there are beautiful jewelry making videos on YouTube which you could refer, and hours they can spend on creating these beautiful jewelry. So these kind of beading activities are really good for fine motor skills, and they're busy creating them for hours. Play-dohs are very good for cognitive skill learning, and you could actually make Play-doh at home, and it's not very difficult. There's no cooking required, it's just the mixing, and I'm sharing a Play-doh making recipe in my description box. You could give ice cream molds or ice trays from your kitchen, and kids can create lots of alphabets and shapes out of Play-dohs, and it can keep them busy for hours. Baking could be another activity which can keep them busy, and there's lots of learnings involved with them. It gives us opportunity to interact with children, and they learn practical skills. You could do pizza making, scones making, cookies. You could do cookie decoration with them. Just take a digestive or Griffin's biscuit and spread some Nutella and give them some decorative stuff to decorate the cookies. Ask them to set up the evening tea table and enjoy the cookies with them. Please make sure that you are reading a book, especially storybook, to children, because storybooks are really good for their imaginary skills and creative thinking. And kids love to listen to the stories repeatedly. So there's no worries even if you are reading the same book and same story for weeks. Sometimes balloons are just lying in the house, and we think only when there's a birthday party or some occasion we'll take them out. So try to give them balloons every day, and they can actually play with balloon for hours. If you give them a paper plate and attach a straw, glue the straw with it and make it like a racket. So this racket and balloon game is quite interesting for them. Balloon and racket play is very good for their hand and eye coordination. You could teach them about fruits and vegetables while you are in your kitchen. Try to have a conversation where you leave them think. Let them touch and feel the fruits and vegetables. Fruits and vegetables are good for their sensory play and practical learning skills. I remember in my childhood using potatoes in my painting and coloring. Give them a basket and ask them to collect fallen leaves, petals, sticks, some pines or some shells from your garden, so that they learn about the environment and they can use these resources in their painting and in their coloring to create some patterns and effects. In a disposable cup, you can add some compost and add some seeds and ask them to water every day. When they are watching that seed growing, it's really good learning for them. Since New Zealand weather is still not that bad, you could do some water fun with them. And if you are not interested in doing some water play outdoors, you could create some water activities in bathroom. So in bathtub, you could add some colors in the water or add some marbles or any floating toys and make it interesting and water play fun for them. The next activity you can do is bubbles. If you don't have bubbles at home, don't worry. Give them some shaving foam. You could give them in a box or in a bathtub and add some colors to it and make it more interesting. Kids love to play with foam. All of us have enjoyed this activity in our childhood. For their hand and eye coordination, playing with bubbles is a very good exercise. Have a picnic in your backyard or set up a tent in your garden. Or you could set up a family lunch table or a mat for picnic. But please make sure that you are being in your bubble. In your garden, you can actually dig a corner where kids can do some sand play and you can leave some animals or some shells or natural resources for them to enjoy. And you could simply play ball or football outdoor in the garden, and if you have pets, include them. You could use empty water bottles or empty egg trays to make a bird feeder. Just tie it with a string and hang it on a tree, and then just simply watch your kids watching the birds coming there for food. If you have spare tires, just put them outside and put a plank on these tires and ask them to do a balancing activity. Or you could ask them to keep a book on their head and balance. Or simply paint the pebbles lying in your garden. You could paint a ladybug and just leave it in the pebbles for them to find it. Or simply include them in your laundry activities. You could give them pegs. Little pegs are actually very good for their fine motor skills. Art and craft has great impact on children for developing their communication skills. It helps children to express their emotions and feelings. When they feel proud of art and work they have done, it boosts their confidence and it helps in their self-esteem levels. Simply giving them paper cutting, paper pasting and glue can keep them busy for hours. So guided art and craft activities actually very good for their learning, and there are heaps of simple art and craft work YouTube videos which you could watch to create some beautiful art and craft. So it will definitely help their confidence. Art and craft work and paper cutting will surely give you little tiny papers on the carpet or floor. So these kids can be included in the cleaning process, and you could give them some wet wipes or tissues to clean the windows or the furniture, and you could give them little dustpan and broom to collect those tiny papers. Kids love to do cleaning. Kids love to follow what adults do. So you could give them some travel spray bottles and ask them to spray on the windows and wipe them. Costume play is good for their imaginary skills and their creative thinking. You could create some animals costumes or teach them animal sounds through this play. If you don't have enough costumes at home, not to worry. You could use your makeup, or you could use your simply scarves to create some costumes around the characters or animals you are sharing the story. Besides costume play, pretend play is another activity which is very good for their imaginary skills and creative thinking. Sometimes you become the doctor, they become the patient, or you become the baby and they become the parents. You could do lots of roles with them, looking after a baby, or you could become a doctor, a nurse, or ice cream seller. So this way you can actually teach them practical skills. The next activity, matching and sorting, is very good for their brain development and
problem solving.
You could do some puzzles with them, or you could give them some stuff from the house. I've collected few milk bottle tops here, and from different bottles, like from different juice bottles we use at home. So all the different colors are put in a box where they sort them color wise and count them. So here you give them opportunity for teaching them numbers and teaching them colors. So these matching and sorting activities are actually very good for their brain development. Even if you don't have enough toys at home, not to worry. You could give them some utensils from your kitchen. For example, you can give them a tong and a muffin tray along with some pom-pom balls. Or even if you don't have colorful pom-pom balls, you could make balls from your cotton balls. They love to pick up those pom-pom balls, and shifting from one mold to another mold keeps them busy for hours. And this is a very good exercise for their fine motor skills. Similarly, you can give them empty ice tray with pom-pom balls for this. From your kitchen, on a plate, you could give them some colorful kidney beans, pastas, lentils, chickpeas, black chickpeas, corns. Just make a plate quite attractive and colorful for them. While you're working in kitchen, you could have a conversation where you can ask them colors or ask them to count. They can be kept busy alongside your cooking. You could give them different shapes of pastas and few boxes to do pouring. They love to do placing and pouring and making and empty and filling. So these sort of activities are actually very good for their fine motor skills and for their brain development. You could give them some disposable cups to make structures. Simply with paper, you could create a boat or an aeroplane. Give them water in a tub or in a box along with a paper boat, and let them explore how water and paper reacts when they are together. Similarly, you can give them paper aeroplane and have an aeroplane contest in the family. If you have bubble paper, bubble wrapping paper in your garage, just spread it on the floor. Kids love that popping sound. Or simply put the mask tape on the carpet or on the sofa or wherever you feel fit, and just give them little cars to race on that track which you created. You could give spaghetti plate to them. Just cut your wool in a different color wool and give it in a ball to play a messy play. And it's not that messy, it's a clean play. Give them some musical instrument time. You could give them some utensils to play as a musical instrument. For example, you could give empty formula box and a spoon to create a drum. If you have small insects, small plastic insect toys, just freeze them in ice. Kids love to watch those insects frozen in the ice.
Give them different color ribbons and put it in an empty wipe box or tissue box. They love to pull out when different colors are coming out. You could write down all the activities you plan to offer on colorful paper slips by putting them in a jar and asking them to pick up one slip. Surely they will have fun when they are given choice to choose.
I hope you found these activities useful, and stay safe, and keep asking your kids to wash hands. And you can make washing hands a fun activity, make it musical. There's a rhyme available, Wash Your Hands, on YouTube. You can download in your phone and sing along. So stay safe, stay inside, enjoy the break. Thank you.